Hello students, myself Om Prakash Katte and we are discussing today class 11 chapter biomolecules, and very important topic of the biomolecule chapter is activation energy, concept of activation energy. Students, the concept of activation energy, it is little bit tough for you, it's little bit difficult to understand the concept of the activation energy, but we are trying to understand the concept by the easy manner. So look at our topic, it's the concept of activation energy. Before starting the concept of activation energy, we must remember enzyme, most of the enzymes are the proteins in nature. And these are the biocatalysts. So enzymes are the biocatalysts which take parts in the chemical reaction. They increase the rate of chemical reaction. So first we have learned, in absence of the enzyme in chemical reaction, in absence of enzyme, suppose one chemical reaction is given, carbon dioxide when react with the water, it's from the H2CO3 carbonic acid. So, if CO2 is combined with water and it forms the carbonic acid, here 200 molecules per hour of H2CO3 are formed. In absence of enzyme, CO2 combined with water and about 200 molecules of H2CO3 are formed per hour. If in presence of enzyme, here the absence of enzyme, 200 molecules per hour are formed of H2CO3, carbonic acid. If presence of enzyme, if enzymes is present, here CO2 combined with water, it forms the carbonic anhydrase enzyme is present. So, water, CO2 is combined with the water, in presence of carbonic anhydrase, it also forms the carbonic acid H2CO3, but in presence of enzyme, 6 lakh molecules of H2CO3 are formed in per second. Here you will see, without enzyme, only 200 molecules per hour are formed. But if the enzyme is present, here 6 lakh molecules per second are formed of H2CO3. It's very clear that enzyme is a enhance the rate of chemical reaction. So, we have to understand here first one, the what is the role of enzyme. Second important part which we are discussing, and it is the how is enzyme act or action of enzyme. So, students, we have learned enzyme action, mechanism of enzyme. Here, this enzyme and this S is stand for substrate. E for enzyme and S is for substrate. If they combine together, ES is from the enzyme substrate complex. Okay. So, enzyme action, how is enzyme action caused? So, this is the one diagram of the enzyme. This is the enzyme. And this enzyme, it is having the active site of enzyme. This is called the active site of the enzyme. So, each enzyme is having the active site. Now, substrate, this is the one substrate, and this one I am indicating as a S. So, enzyme is having the active site, this is the enzyme and it is the active site and it is the substrate. So, during the chemical reaction, the substrate is combined with the active site of the enzyme. So, the diagram will be this one. This is the enzyme active site, and with this active site, this substrate is combined. So, when the substrate is combined with the active site of the enzyme, this one ES is formed. It is called the enzyme substrate complex. And this state where substrate combined with the active site of the enzyme, and this one enzyme substrate complex is formed. So, this state is called the transitional state. Transition state. We should understand first, Buttish transitions that when substan is combined with the active side of the enzyme, it forms the ES, it means enzyme substan complex, and this is called the transition state. One more definition. What do you mean by transition state? It is the state of the substrate by giving the energy to produce product. It is so when substrate by giving the energy and it forms the product. So this one, when substrate combined with the enzyme, one unstable state comes. This is the transition state. In this transition state now, this substance will convert into, substrate will convert into product. So that state, it promote the substrate to convert into the product. So this state is called the transitional state. So what is transitional state? It is the state in which substrate is combined with the active site of enzyme, and now from the substrate, the product will be formed. Students, after this one, transitional state, we should remember two important graphs and reaction. So we have two types of reaction. One reaction is called exothermic reaction, and another is called endothermic reaction. So one is exothermic and another is endothermic. So one axis here potential energy, and these are indicated the reactant and substrate. I am taking the substrate here and it is the potential energy. So when potential energy and substrate, here one reaction is called exothermic reaction. When we call the exothermic reaction, when the it is the substrate and this is the product. This is P is for product and the S is for substrate. When the energy level, this you can understand from this level to this level, this is the potential energy substrate and this is the S is for substrate. So here you will see, here is substrate, the potential energy of substrate is this one, this much. But the potential energy of product is this one. Here it is indicated, when product, P is for product and S is for the substrate. If product energy level of product is less than the substrate, it means energy level of substrate is more and as compared to energy level of product. So we can say when product energy level of product is less than the substrate, so this reaction is called the exothermic reaction. Or other word we can say, reaction in which energy level of substrate is more as compared to energy level of product. So, when energy level of product is lower than the substrate, here you will see energy level of product is less as compared to substrate. So, this reaction is called the exothermic reaction. But in other graph you will see, graph number 2, here it is S and it is P. This one is P. P it means for product and this one is S, it means substrate. If we will see energy level here, so substrate energy level is low and energy level of product is high. So such type of reaction where the energy level of product is more as compared to substrate, and it is called endothermic reaction. Or simply we can say, exothermic reaction is the reaction in which the energy is released, and endothermic reaction, it is the reaction in which energy is consumed for the reaction. So we have two type of reaction now. Exothermic reaction, when energy level of product, this one, is lower than the substrate. So this reaction is called the exothermic reaction, whereas if energy level of product is more than the S, it means substrate. It means other word we can say, if the energy level of substrate is less than the energy level of product, so this reaction is called endothermic reaction. So first we have learned about the role of enzyme. Then we have learned how the enzymes substance combine with the active site of enzyme, and this state is called the transitional state. After this transitional state, the substrate is converted into the product. So, but this is the unstable state. Enzyme and substrate both combine, and it forms the enzyme substrate complex, and this state is called the transition state. After this transitional state, this substrate will convert into the product. So there are two types of reaction, one exothermic reaction and another endothermic reaction. So endothermic reaction, we have learned, reaction in which the energy is required. So if energy is required for the reaction, it is called endothermic reaction. Now we have to look at toward the another concept now. It is the activation energy. What is activation energy? So activation energy, first you will see, as I told you, the enzyme plus substrate, this combine, then it form enzyme substrate complex, and later it's a convert into product. It convert into product. So what is happening? This substrate have to be converted into product. This substrate required the minimum amount of the energy to change into the transition state, and then it convert into the product. So what happened? This substrate required some amount of energy, so it's come in the transitional state, and then it form the product. So that amount of energy required to the substrate to change into transitional state, so that after transitional state, this substrate can convert into product. So this amount of energy is called activation energy. What is activation energy? The minimum amount of energy required to bring the substrate molecule in transitional state is known as activation energy. In simply, we also can say external energy which required to start the chemical reaction. Here you understand, this substrate will convert into product. Substrate is converted into the product. Okay, so but substrate have to be activated. So for the activation of the substrate, because the substrate activation is what? The substrate is combined with the active site of the enzyme, and it come in the transition state. So this state is called activated state. So when substrate required the minimum amount of energy, and it's come in the transitional state, so the substrate can convert into product. So this amount of energy is called activation energy. Activation energy is what? External energy which required to start the chemical reaction. So activation energy definition is very simple. It's the amount of energy is required the substrate to comes in the transition state, and then it convert into substrate, it convert into product. So it is called activation energy. Here in this graph, activation energy is depicted. So if you will see, so in this graph, two axes are there. Axis X, here it shows the progress of the reaction, so chemical reaction. Progress of the chemical reaction. And axis Y, it's the potential energy. So when chemical reaction start, so this is called the progress of continuity of the chemical reaction. And it shows axis is how much amount of potential energy is required. So it is the graph between progress of reaction on x-axis and potential energy. Here you will see one substrate, S is for substrate and P is for product. So, substrate, as I told you, this substrate combined with enzyme, it forms the enzyme substrate complex. To look at it. This substrate and this is source, this is the substrate, S is substrate and this is the P is for the product. Now, first one, this is called the activation energy. This one is the activation energy and this is also level of activation energy. But here the activation energy is a less and here the activation energy is more. So this activation energy without enzyme. Where the level of activation energy is high, it's due to the activation energy without enzyme. And second is this one, it is represent, activation energy with enzyme. Now, again we can understand activation energy is what? It's the amount of energy required to activate the substrate so the substrate can combine with the enzyme and it come in the transition state. And then it's a substrate convert into product. So that amount of the energy required, this is called the activation energy. So it is our substrate and S is for substrate and P is for the product. Now, first one graph you will see, the substrate continuously is a substrate is continuously changed into the product. So, here is the high peak where the maximum substance can convert into product. But beyond it, the rate of production of the product can be decreased. So, here we can understand only, in the first one, the activation energy with enzyme, it is very low. It means, in chemical reaction, if enzymes are involved, in chemical reaction, if the enzymes are involved, they require less activation energy. But if activation energy without enzyme is high, so if no enzymes are involved, in such cases, activation energy, it means more amount of energy is required to induce the substrate to come in the transitional state. So this graph, it shows that, this graph shows that if the enzymes are involved, in such cases, the substrate required less activation energy and they change into transitional state and then into the product. So, if enzymes are involved, if no enzymes are here, in such cases, the substrate required more activation energy. So, this one higher activity or activation energy is high. So this activation energy is high. What does it show? This is the activation energy without enzyme. But here substrate required less amount of activation energy if the enzyme. So here in absence of enzyme, what happened? In absence of enzyme, more activation energy is required to bring. Here more activation energy is required to bring the substrate to transitional state and such cases less product are formed. So in absence of enzyme, more activation energy is required and to bring the substrate into transitional state and less product are formed. But in presence of enzyme, less activation energy, activation energy is required to bring the substrate to the transition state. Transition state is what? It is the state, unstable state, where the substance is combined with enzyme active site, and this step is called the transitional step. Later, substrate is converted into the product. So, it is the transitional step, the step in which substrate combined with the active site of the enzyme, and then it converts substrate into product. And second, it is potential energy. This shows the progression of reaction, S is for substrate and P. So, if substrate and product we compare as a potential energy, so what we can observe, if the enzyme is present, in such cases, less activation energy is required to the substrate to come in transitional state. But without enzyme, the substrate requires more activation energy to come in the transitional state. So, this graph is very important, as well as definition of transitional state is very important. Many times the transitional, what is transitional state? This is asked, and activation energy with enzyme is low, and yet activation energy without enzyme is higher. So, it is at all about the activation energy. Thank you.